Welcome to Lucid Mind Chemistry Channel. In this video, I have put together some questions related to the topic Properties of Alcohol. For links to other topics and question timestamps, please visit video description. Question 21. What is the correct name for the compound shown? Let's count the number of carbon atoms. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon atoms in the long chain. We have 2 CH3 substituents and 1 OH as a substituent. We have 5 carbon atoms in the long chain. With second carbon, we have OH group. On third carbon, we have 2 methyl groups attached. Rest are the number of hydrogen atoms. The numbering will start from this carbon as the substituents have less number. On third carbon, we have 2 methyl groups. On second carbon, we have alcohol. So we can write 3,3 dimethyl. The long chain is of 5 carbons. So for 5 carbon, we will write pentane. And on second carbon, we have alcohol group. So we will write 2-ol. The correct option is therefore C.
Question 37. Cortisone is a synthetic hormone. This is the structure of cortisone. Which classes of alcohol does this molecule contain? We have primary, secondary, and tertiary alcohol. Now you should remember that if the carbon bonded with the OH is bonded to no other carbon atom, or if it is bonded to only one other carbon atom, then it is primary alcohol. If the carbon bonded to OH is further attached directly with two other carbon atoms, then it is secondary alcohol. And if this carbon is attached with three other carbon atoms directly, it is tertiary alcohol. Let's look at the OH groups. This is OH, this is OH, and this is OH. We only have three alcohol groups. So we can look at these three carbon atoms. This carbon atom is directly attached with two other carbon atoms. One is this one, one is this one. So therefore, this is secondary alcohol functional group. This carbon of OH is further directly attached with three other carbon atoms, 1, 2, 3. So therefore, this is tertiary alcohol. And this carbon atom is directly attached with only one carbon atom. So therefore, it is primary alcohol. As all three options are correct, answer is A. Question 21. How many tertiary alcohols have the molecular formula C6H14O? Tertiary alcohols are such alcohols in which OH functional group is attached with tertiary carbon. Now, tertiary carbon is that carbon which is directly attached to at least three carbon atoms. Let's draw tertiary alcohols having molecular formula C6H14O. We can have 5 carbon atoms in the long chain. OH functional group is present, and this carbon is directly attached with 3 carbon atoms. Now this is tertiary alcohol. Rest are the number of hydrogen atoms. Molecular formula is C6H14, and we have 1 oxygen atom. For naming, we are going to start numbering from this carbon atom as OH functional group is nearer. We have 5 carbon atoms in the long chain. On second carbon, we have alcohol functional group. We also have methyl group. So it is 2-methyl pentane, and OH is on second carbon, so it is 2-ol. Now we can shift the position of this OH to third carbon. The structure will be like this. As this carbon is tertiary carbon, so therefore it is attached to three carbon atoms directly. Rest are the hydrogen atoms. Molecular formula is again C6H14O. And the naming can be started from either end. It will be 3-hydroxy, pentane, then we have on third carbon atom methyl group. So 3-methyl, pentane, 3-ol. Another possible structure can be drawn if we move this carbon to this carbon atom. Let's draw this structure. We have 4 carbon atoms in the long chain. General formula is still C6H14O. And we can do the naming. OH functional group is nearer to this carbon, so it will be 4 carbon chain. Now the name is 2,3-dimethyl. Then we have long chain of 4 carbon, so it is butane. And on second carbon we have alcohol, it is 2-ol. These three are the only possible structures for tertiary alcohol, so therefore answer is C. Question 37, compound X has the structure shown. This is compound X. We can see there are two functional groups. One is of tertiary alcohol. Second is carbonyl carbon of ketone. Which statements about compound X are correct? 1. X will decolorize cold acidified KMnO4. Now, cold acidified KMnO4 cannot oxidize tertiary alcohol. It can also not oxidize or convert ketone group into any compound. So therefore this is wrong. 2. X gives an orange precipitate with 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine reagent. Now we know that 2,4-DNPH is actually used for the presence of carbonyl carbon, whether it is aldehyde or ketone. If carbonyl carbon is present of aldehyde and ketone, then 2,4-DNPH always gives positive result and orange precipitate is formed. In this structure carbonyl carbon is present, so therefore 2 is correct. 3 says X does not react with tollens reagent. Now tollens reagent can oxidize aldehyde, but it cannot oxidize ketone. As this says does not react, it means it is true because we have ketone present here, there is no aldehyde, so therefore tollens reagent will not react. So option 1 is incorrect, only correct options are 2 and 3, therefore answer is C. Question 39, which statements about 2-methylbutane-1-ol are correct? Number 1, it can give HCl gas on reaction with BCl5. Now let's write 2-methylbutane-1-ol. In butane we have 4 carbon atoms. 1-ol means that OH is attached on the first carbon atom, and on second carbon atom methyl group is attached. Rest are the hydrogen atoms. Upon reaction with BCl5 at room temperature, what happens is that OH is replaced by Cl. Along with POCl3 and HCl. So HCl gas is formed in this reaction, so statement 1 is correct. Number 2, it can be oxidized to give an aldehyde, as we have primary alcohol, and primary alcohol can be oxidized to form aldehyde. The product will be like this. Statement 2 is correct. Number 3, it displays optical isomerism. Now for optical isomerism, chiral carbon should be present. Chiral carbon is the one having 4 different elements and groups directly attached. We can see this carbon is attached to 1 hydrogen, 1 CH3, 1 CH2OH and 1 CH2CH3. So this is chiral carbon and it will display optical isomerism. All 3 options are correct. Answer is A. Question 21. Which pair of alcohols are isomers of each other? Now, isomers means those compounds that have same molecular formula but different structures. In A, we have butane 1-ol, so in long chain, we have 4 carbon atoms for butane. And on first carbon, we have alcohol group attached. Rest of the number of hydrogen atoms. So the molecular formula is C4H10O. Second is 2,2-dimethylpropane-1-ol. So in long chain, we have 3 carbon atoms as it is propane. And on second carbon, we have 2 methyl groups attached. While on first carbon, we have alcohol group present. Rest are the number of hydrogen atoms. The molecular formula is C4H12O. As we can see, molecular formula is different, so A is incorrect. In B, we have butane 2-ol. We have 4 carbon atoms in butane, and on second carbon atom, we have OH functional group. Rest are the number of hydrogen atoms. The molecular formula is C4H10O. Second is 2-methylpropane-2-ol. As we have propane, so there are 3 carbon atoms in the long chain. On second carbon, we have methyl group and also OH group. Rest are the hydrogen atoms. The molecular formula is C4H10O. As we can see, the structure is different and the molecular formula is same, so therefore B could be correct. For C, we have pentane 1-ol and 2-methylpropane-2-ol, as this is the same one. Let's draw the structure of pentane 1-ol. In pentane, we have 5 carbon atoms in long chain. And 1-ol means OH is attached with the first carbon. As we can see that the number of carbon atoms are 5, while in 2-methylpropane-1-ol, the number of carbon atoms is 4. Therefore, these are not isomers. In D, we have propane 2-ol. In propane, we have 3 carbon atoms, and on second carbon, we have OH group attached. Molecular formula is C3H8O. As number of carbon atoms and hydrogen is different, so therefore D is also not isomer. Correct answer is therefore B. Question 21. X has the molecular formula C5H12O. X has a branched carbon skeleton and a secondary alcohol functional group. How many structural isomers fit in the description of X? Let's draw the branch structure of C5H12O. So we have 5 carbon atoms. 4 carbon atoms are in the long chain, while 5th one is as a branch. Now we have secondary alcohol functional group also attached. Secondary alcohol means it is attached with the carbon atom that is directly attached with 2 carbon atoms. So this is the only position for secondary alcohol. Other structures of C5H12O could be like this. Or like this. This is wrong because in this one we don't have a branched carbon skeleton, and this is wrong because now we have tertiary alcohol as compared to secondary alcohol. So the only possible structure is this one. The answer is therefore A.
Thanks for watching. If this was useful, please do like, subscribe, and share.